There are rumors flying right now that DEI requirements at Disney are going so far as to endanger park attendees because of, I guess, malfunctions going on in Tiana's Bayou Adventure, which, if you don't know the lore behind this, this is a new ride at Disney because they decided to completely replace and remodel the old ride it was based on because it was racist.
Yeah.
It was based on Song of the South, very old Disney movie that was kind of considered racist decades later because it had the magical Negro trope in it, and they decided that that could not stand Disney anymore, and they remodeled it based on Tiana, the Black Disney princess, and added a bunch of animatronics to it. But this video was posted recently saying, Tiana's Bayou Adventure has done several in-show exits today. The ride keeps breaking down and guests must be escorted off by cast members with work lights on. Credit to a channel called Farmeritaville for this footage that confirms what I was hearing.
Okay. Well, this was our second lap and the work lights came on and we stopped at this point and we've been here about 5 minutes. And they just turned off the music and said on the PA that cast members will be by to evacuate us momentarily. So we're gonna get evacuated off Tiana's Splash Mountain Bayou Adventure. Woo!
So in response, Mark Kern tweeted out, look at what is happening with Tiana's Bayou Adventure. I do not trust any Disney engineered rides, especially anything with drops or high speeds. Disney has embraced DEI, didn't earn it, over MEI, Merit, Excellence, Intelligence, and is headed for Boeing-level problems. The risk to our kids is too great.
I mean, I feel like extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence.
So basically the theory here is they're hiring a bunch of engineers for these rides for DEI quotas. Yeah. Who are not qualified to be working on that level of technology, and it could lead to deaths.
Is there any evidence
and
that this is true?
Maimings for park attendees.
There's a $50 one there from St. Miles. Says, heard the word cookies on my earbuds, hoping that this helps to match Brett's age. Traffic is moving again. I'm glad the traffic is moving again.
Thank you for the big super chat.
Do you want to know how dumb I am? When you said, like, let's get to 38, it didn't even occur to me that that was, like, my age in 38 crisis parties.
Yeah, we're gonna reach 38 crisis parties. I can feel it.
Didn't even occur to me. So here's what Lorena Creel says. She says, my annoyance aside with the DEI, with the didn't earn it nonsense, this ride breaking down has zero to do with a DEI accusation and everything to do with C-suite level idiots not giving Imagineering the time needed to deliver a successful attraction.
Well, I think that some people would argue the Imagineers are not giving it the proper amount of thought or planning because they were hired in DEI quotas rather than by merit. That's what they would argue.
I have no idea.
However,
if any of that is true.
If it has a seed of truth for Boeing, I can only assume that would happen at other companies. Thank you.
I just saw another crazy one from Boeing today. Oh, what was that one? I saw a crazy one from Air Europa on Boeing today. Let me see if I can pull that up. Hold on.
We got another 20 from Pork Stuff.
What did he say?
He said, happy birthday, Bert. Y'all are the perfect background for the worst part of my day. Thanks for that. You're welcome.
Like, oh yeah, there was this one. It's man stuck in overhead compartment.
Oh my gosh, how does that even happen?
I have no idea. I saw this earlier.
He was raw dogging the flight.
He was. That's what it was.
What is this?
That's me and Tiana's Bayou.
How does that even happen? How did he even get up there? Like,
oh, hey, is this the flight to Malaysia?
Was he trying to stow away? Oh my goodness. Insane.
Yep. Who was I talking to recently about whether they, like a lot of people don't realize that these types of things have always happened on flights. It's just, it's getting a lot more attention now with what's going on with Boeing and the whistleblowers and all of the Hitman Agent 47 memes that have been made about Boeing and all of that stuff.
You could say it's getting more attention now and malfunctions always happened, but I do believe that there is some truth to the DEI quotas risking people's lives.
I mean, I just also believe that this is one of those things where that could be it, or it could be that people who operate the C-suite, which we just talked about last week with James O'Keefe, they don't really understand, you know, how the creative side of these businesses work. All they know is deadlines and numbers and not how to actually get things done. And if deadlines are pushed and they're not given adequate time to create things, that could be a reason as well. I'm just saying, unless I get like a memo that says like, this person was hot. Do you know what I'm saying?
Well, the incompetence will extend to all levels, not just C-suite executives. That's, I think, the point you're
trying to make. No, I'm saying that it's not that necessarily the C-suite executives are just incompetent.
Big super chat from Talking and Drawing with Shane Davis. Yo! Happy birthday, Brett.
Shane, what's going on,
dude? Thank you so much.
I'm going to like that one. Thank you.
You were saying something?
I was saying like, yeah, so executives, it can be that executives are incompetent, but also that they don't understand how the other departments really, really work, right? And if they move up deadlines and stuff like this, again, I don't have any memos in front of me that claim this to be the fact. I just know that we've turned DEI into a catch-all reason to blame anything that goes wrong at any company.
You think it's becoming a bit of a boogeyman?
I think it's very easy that incompetence is always very common in these industries, and it doesn't always have to do with one type of incompetence.
It didn't used to be, especially at Disney. I think they used to put a lot more care and thought into their operations on every level.
I mean, we're in hard times financially, inflation wise. Companies could be just cost cutting measures. Mm-hmm. Not necessarily hiring practices, but cost-cutting measures, moved up deadlines. I just see a lot of other things that you could put as a reason for this, aside from that, barring any proof that that's actually what it was.
There's also a retort from a former Imagineer.
So here's the thing. What I'm making is basically what this guy's argument kind of was, but the guy is so insufferable in how he phrases it that it makes me want him to be wrong.
Yeah, he said, "Hi, former Disney employee here. I actually worked at the parks and, unlike you, know something about ride safety and attraction maintenance. 90% of the time, shutdowns happen because a guest does something stupid. Standard procedure is a full evacuation and reset. Be quiet." And then he went on to say, every attraction on Disney property is checked every night by the maintenance team, then checked again in the morning and fully cycled, often several times by the ops team before park open. If a ride doesn't pass any of those checks, it doesn't open, period. It is hard to fathom, unless you've worked at a theme park, how many times these rides operate in a day, much less a calendar year. Guests do a lot of stupid stuff that forces shutdowns and evacuations. Stuff breaks, a sensor being tripped accidentally can lead to a ride shutdown. These rides are extremely safe and effective. Disney has some of the most stringent safety regulations in the world, and the people who work there are certainly more competent than some Twitter grifter who doesn't know what a linear synchronous motor is and can't explain a ride cascade. Last thing, since what kicked off is about the attraction formerly known as Splash Mountain, Splash is a maintenance nightmare.
Thank you.
Old water ride, lots of animation, absolutely huge, always had issues. Sensors and water is a bad mix. That doesn't mean it's unsafe, though.
Here's the thing. Like, I made an argument to the contrary, but I want this guy to be wrong because he's just such a douche.
Yeah, as I would assume a lot of people who work at Disney are douches.
And blaming the guests is never the right idea if you're trying to ingratiate yourselves to paying customers.
Well, it is probably the guests a lot of the time, yeah. But true.
Yeah.
True for a PR perspective.
Like, the idea is, you know, there's a reason where the phrase, you know, the customer is always right comes from, even if it's not true. It's just good operating practice.
Would you ever go to Disney?
No, I don't. I don't care about theme parks. Though that's
in general.
In general, I don't really. Maybe Maybe Universal, just because it's not Disney.
Yeah, I've never been to Disney, and I honestly just, I was never one of those kids that wanted to go to Disney. Yeah. Like, that was never a dream of mine, and I wasn't raised watching a lot of Disney stuff.
So. Yeah, it wouldn't resonate with you in the same way.
We weren't a Disney family.
It wouldn't resonate with you the same way that it would with people who grew up really. Here's the thing. I would go there and I'd end up walking past like the weird swingers on Main people who'd be like walking the other way. That's what would happen to me.
Just your luck.
I wouldn't have any
luck.
That's
why they're making bank on millennials these days.
Thanks for watching. Listen to full episodes of Pop Culture Crisis on Spotify.
Keep up with us on social media and make sure you subscribe and ring that bell so you never miss the show. Bye, guys.